Hello and welcome to a new video of Explore Bio on Research and Publishing. If you are planning for a PhD, one of the first things you are asked to write is a research synopsis or PhD synopsis. Recently, I have received a request to make a video on it, so here it is. I have been into research since last 11 years, and I have gone through various phases of it. So my purpose is to help those who are struggling in research or publishing through these videos. You can write to me at explorebio@yahoo.com. If it is within my scope, I will be happy to help you. In today's video, in very simple terms, you will learn what is a research synopsis, what is its importance, what is a general format for writing a synopsis, what aspects it should cover, and I will try to cover everything you would need to know to write a perfect research synopsis. So watch it till the end. A research synopsis is a document that summarizes what you will be doing in your PhD, how you are going to do it, and what methodology you will follow. This is usually submitted at the beginning of your PhD. Writing a synopsis is not that difficult once you have a clear idea of your proposed PhD work. Based on your research synopsis, the research committee evaluates and decides whether your work is significant and doable within the given time frame. Based on the methodology, the committee gets an idea how clear you are about carrying forward your experiments. At the same time, a research synopsis helps the PhD candidate to stay focused in his or her research throughout the PhD journey. Therefore, a student should invest ample of time reading relevant papers, planning, discussing with the PhD supervisor, and writing a good synopsis. A synopsis can be written under various heads. The first heading, which should be finalized at last, is the title. Summarizing what your whole research is about in one or max two sentences of a title really needs a calm and clear mind. Next comes the introduction. Here you mention the background of the proposed work, the existing information relevant to the proposal, missing link, or the knowledge gap. What you will do to fill this gap or find an answer to a research problem. Do not forget to cite the papers you referred. Synopsis introduction is similar to the introduction that is written in a research paper. In literature review section, you write a paragraph or two about the work already done in the area you are proposing and is important to be aware of while planning your own research. This is very important to know because there would be no sense of doing the same work that has already been done and published by someone else. Based on existing information and what is lacking, you and your supervisor decides to design the proposed work. You can refer previously published research articles, reviews, book chapters, reports from authentic agencies like WHO, FAO, ICMR for literature review. For synopsis, just include most important literatures, probably 10 to 20 relevant to your work. Also, literature reading builds your concepts and awareness of what is known about the topic that would help you decide what needs to be done. Depending upon the subject area, you may have to go through dozens of research papers before you make up your proposal. You may refer my video on how to efficiently read a research paper later. Next, you write the objectives. Usually 2 to 3 clear objectives of your proposed work should be mentioned. Objectives breaks your whole research into smaller quantifiable chunks. Usually, the progress made under each objective during the PhD has to be shown in yearly assessment reports. Next important section of your synopsis is methodology. Here you briefly mention the material or sample you will be using, data collection, procedures, methods you will follow, treatment and control samples, statistics and other computational analysis that will be done. If animal or humans are to be used as model or genetic modification needs to be done, do check if approval from ethical committee is required. At last, you mention the references that you have cited in the introduction, literature review, and methodology sections. Care needs to be taken that all the references are properly formatted. Do make a separate folder for research papers and other articles that you have read and used for writing your research documents. I suggest you to use a reference manager to cite the references in your synopsis. This helps you to automatically format the references, avoiding mistakes, and saves a lot of time. I have made a separate tutorial on reference management software. You may refer to it later. Depending upon the university or the institutional guidelines for the synopsis writing, hypothesis can be mentioned after literature review or the objective section. Hypothesis should not be vague. After critically thinking about the existing information and your imagination, you come up with a hypothesis. Hypothesis is based upon the predictions that you think might be right, but is not necessary to be true. If you are asked to include an abstract, you may include it after the title. More details about how to write an abstract is given in my another video. Proofread your synopsis, get it checked by your colleagues, and finally from your supervisor before submitting it. Synopsis is the first important research document you write. A great synopsis is the one that delivers maximum information in minimum words. Just remember to keep it short, covering only essential details, as further details can be later mentioned in your final thesis. Ideally, a synopsis should be between 1000 to 4000 words, so it is important to include what is important and exclude that is not necessary for a synopsis. If a research synopsis is asked at a later stages prior to thesis submission, you additionally have to mention the results of the research work too. I hope the video will help you writing your synopsis. If you are new in the field of research, I recommend to watch my videos on how to choose a research topic, how to choose a research supervisor, how to write a research article or a review, and lots of such videos on research and publishing series. Thanks, and stay connected for more such videos.